It's not that Britain is unequal. Pretty much every society on the planet is unequel. It's the lies that we tell ourselves.
We pretend that it isn't.
We pretend it isn't. We pretend that we've achieved. We're not Sweden. And even Sweden's got problems. We're not Norway. And even Norway's got. We're not Japan. The first time I was searched by the police, I was 12.
Yes.
There was no adult present. I wasn't read my rights. So a teacher at my school gave us, all of the young black boys in our school, he gave us a form with our rights on it. Because he knew it was going to get searched by the police at some point. So it's like, it doesn't matter what your grades are. I mean, you can be like me and go to the Royal Institution of Mathematics. I actually got searched. I'll talk about this once in the book.
Yeah.
I got searched on my way to the Royal Institution of Mathematics masterclasses once. And that was when it hit me. It was like, respectability politics don't mean anything. Because I was born in the bottom 1 or 2% of, you know, socioeconomically speaking. Academically, I was in the top 1 or 2%. It didn't change the fact that some of the people with the power just saw a criminal. And this was before I did become a bit of a naughty boy myself, and part of that trajectory was being treated like a criminal. It's interesting because I didn't tell my mum when I got home because I couldn't be bothered. Like, it was like, oh, okay, cool. I knew this was coming.
Seriously.
And so, yeah, because it's a rite of passage. This is what happens when you have a stigmatory language.
Sure.
So the last time I got pulled over to Taylor and the two, it was a week, literally a week. It was so ironic. After the commissioner of the Met went on TV and said, tougher sentences for teenage thugs, and black men in London are 20 times more likely to be killed, which is a very selective way of presenting the information. If you're saying blackness is the common denominator, the way to present the information would be to say, what percentage of black people actually kill people? The percentage of black people actually kill people is significantly less than 1%, which means you're going to have to offer more of a common denominator than blackness.
Yeah.
But when you present blackness as the common denominator, even when a significant portion of the black-on-black violence stats are people like me who are half white, you get a situation where police can pull over a grown man and he's 34 years old and say, gang members drive cars like this. And I'm like, well, so do people who run companies, which happens to be what I am. I'm actually on my way to a meeting, but thank you very much. I'm sure that it was the car that made you think I was a gang member. I don't even entirely blame the public, because when you have a language of public policy, when you have a language of media that emphasizes race whenever there's a negative story or a significant portion of time, but not when there's a positive story. So the four youngest kids to ever take GCSEs in Britain are also black. Race was not emphasized in any of the reporting. Six-year-old Joshua Beckford from Tottenham was studying philosophy at Oxford. His dad taught him. Naturally, race and certainly the black father was not emphasized, which in both cases is the case. So again, with the West African kids who are doing very, very well at school, thousands of them, race is not emphasized.
No.
It's emphasized in a negative.
As soon as they go,
it's like the West African kids are doing better than we are. We need to fix this. And it's very interesting because the journalists who are writing that are not concerned with poor white kids failing. They're concerned that poor white kids are failing relative to black kids.
Yes.
They're not actually concerned with poor white kids themselves. It's a sort of weird racial nationalism where, like, we're okay for the chavs to fail.
It's got a touch of the whip hand.
It's okay for the chavs to fail, but they shouldn't be failing more than the immigrants
of
thing. We talk about the 1962 Commonwealth Immigration Act, the act that began the process of de-citizenshipizing, whatever the word is, right? Removing the citizenship from the brown parts of the Commonwealth. The Home Secretary at the time, Rab Butler, privately said, this is now a public statement, he said, its great merit was that it could be presented as non-discriminatory, when in fact its restrictive intent was intended to, and indeed would affect coloured people almost exclusively.
It's supremacism. I know that's a slight, I'm reaching for the big word,
but it is, you keep
saying hierarchical, but you just mean that there is an utterly implicit and occasionally explicit, but only ever in private, sense that, like a caste system.
Yeah, of course. But the difference is, we know that other societies have a caste system.
Yes.
We know that India has a caste system, and we pretend that we don't. And then we say to the people at the bottom of the caste, whether they're the schemies in East Glasgow or the former chavs in East London that now longer exist and have been replaced by West Africans and Bangladeshis, or whoever else it is, the Irish and the Jews of 100 years ago, we say to those people, the results of this caste system are entirely your fault and they're nothing to do with the wider society.
And that's why
it's not that Britain is unequal. Pretty much every society on the planet is unequal. It's the lies that we tell ourselves.
We pretend that it isn't.
We pretend it isn't. We pretend that we've achieved. We're not Sweden. And even Sweden's got problems. We're not Norway. And even Norway's got. We're not Japan. There are countries at similar levels of development. Germany is more. We imprison our population at double the rate the Germans do. And this is one of the ironies of racism, one of the brilliances of it, is that some of the very same people currently demonizing black people as criminals are handing the state power to put their kids in jail.
Yes.
We're 2% of the country. The British prison population has grown by 82% in 3 decades. Do we think that's all black people? We don't live in America. A massive scandal like the fact of thousands of kids essentially getting unfairly expelled from school simply because they're black and their teachers believe they're trouble is no story at all. The fact that young black kids are significantly less likely to be entered for higher tier GCSE, even when they have the same grades as everyone else. The fact that African kids are assumed to be so much less smart than everyone else, even though they're doing so much better in school. And again, these are national studies looking at every school in Britain. It's not me. And I'm not even blaming individual teachers. We live in a world where the only image of Africa is poverty and violence and war. The image of Africa is not the Ghanaian accountant or David Adjaye or the nicest city in Luanda or wherever else, right? There's a particular image, and that has an effect. What the state does is allow popular prejudice to manifest.